welcome. My name is Paige, and I am here with the beautiful Elizabeth Smart. And I want to talk a little bit about your love story with your husband. And so, forgive me if I'm wrong, but you met in Paris. You were both serving as missionaries. And so that's correct, right?
Yes.
And so I just think that is so romantic and beautiful. And so did you guys know right away? Was there just a spark, or how did that even come about?
Well, as we were both missionaries at the time, I think we both knew that we both liked each other, but
right.
We were missionaries and we knew that we needed to focus on doing our missionary work, and that when our missions were over, then we would see where things went. And
right.
So I was a missionary for a year and a half,
okay.
And he was a missionary for 2 years. So when I finished my mission, I started writing handwritten letters,
yeah.
And he started writing me back, and he invited me to Scotland, because that's where he's from.
Okay.
And he said, why don't you come to Scotland when I'm done with my mission?
Mm-hmm.
And so my mind was like, well, I mean, what's the worst that can happen?
Right.
I go and we realize we're just better friends and I have a great trip in Scotland.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I've not been there yet, so why not?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So I went to Scotland, and well, I guess that was the beginning of the end.
Yeah, I just think that is so beautiful. I love hearing love stories where it's very obviously God-ordained. It's very clear that God wrote that love story and that He had that for you your entire life, because you were actually serving God when you met Him. And so I just think it is so beautiful hearing about, you know, stories where people are, you know, both serving, focused on God, and then they just happen to look up and then there's the person. And so it's really great to see. And how long have you two been married now?
We've been married for about 5.5 years.
Okay.
I'm still counting half years.
Okay.
So yes.
Yeah. And so you have two beautiful children. What is it that you guys do for fun? I know earlier we were talking briefly about skiing. Is that so? What exactly do you guys do, and what does life look like for you and your husband and your two children?
So we love to ski. My husband and I, we both love to ski, although I haven't done much in the last 3 years.
Okay.
But my husband and I, we started teaching our daughter how to ski just this past winter, just on the tiny, tiny little, not even the bunny hill,
yeah.
Like the little magic carpet hill.
Okay, cute. Yeah.
And so that's fun. So I'm looking forward to doing that again this winter. But we love just to hang out together and spend time together. And we live up in the mountains, so we love the outdoors.
Right.
And we have a little bonfire pit. We like to have little fires in and roast marshmallows.
Yeah. You have just such a wonderful, calming presence about you. And even your love story, writing handwritten letters back and forth, it's very old-fashioned. But I love it. You know, it's like a breath of fresh air talking with you and just seeing how you live your life and how you spend time with your husband and your children. You go skiing and you have bonfires. It just sounds very quaint and very wonderful. And so it really seems like you've got life figured out.
Oh, well, I don't know about that. We're just
for 29.
The best we can.
Yeah.
We muddled through.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. So to close, I am curious, what is next for you? What are the next 5 years going to bring, the next 10 years? And I know that as soon as we make plans, then God laughs. Just like you said, I'm never going to write a book, I'm never going to speak, and now here you are, but you're doing amazing things with it. Is anything, you know, at the top of your list that you want to continue to conquer? Or, so what are your plans?
Well, yeah, advocacy is a huge part of my life. I mean, my kidnapping completely turned my life in a different direction than what I saw it going in. So I think I probably will still be very heavily involved in the 5 to 10 years and speaking out and advocating and trying to educate people and help bring these issues more into the light. On a shorter time frame, I'm very excited because I recently finished writing my second book, and
wow.
It's due to come out this spring.
Wow.
So I'm so excited about that because I worked so hard on this second book.
Yeah.
I think I'm even more proud of it than my first.
Oh, how exciting.
So I'm really excited for that. It's called Where There's Hope, and it should be coming out end of March or beginning of April.
Okay.
So I'm quite proud, quite excited about that.
Okay.
And, well, in the immediate future, I've got a sister-in-law who's getting married overseas, so shortly we'll be headed back to the UK for a wedding. So
wonderful.
That's kind of like immediate, not so immediate, and far into the future kind of what's going on.
Yeah. Well, I just think that you are so amazing, Elizabeth, and like I mentioned when I first met you, you are just such a great role model for me and for millions of women and just people in general. And so thank you for everything that you do for human trafficking and just with your platform and with your foundation and just with your life and just everything that you do. It's really enlightening to see.
Thank you so much.
So you have been here listening with Paige and Elizabeth Smart with Milk and Honey Magazine. We'll talk to you next time, and thank you again, Elizabeth. Let's go, let's go, let's go.